Before you go in, let me welcome you to Holy Temple Apostolic Deliverance Church here on Christlink. I'm Heather Walker, Choir President and Director. We're so excited to have you with us on today. Be sure to like and share this video and subscribe if you're new. If you'd like to visit with us, here are our services and times. I think you're at your church starting. So let's go.
But today, we see here in Matthew's the 24th chapter, because that's not exactly what I'm talking about today. Verse 3 says, "And as he sat upon Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you. Speak, O God, and we will listen. In Jesus' name, amen and amen." The Lord says, you won't know when I'm coming, but you will know the signs.
That's all right.
We see now that, amen, in our ozone, we see strange things happening in our climate. This is what he was talking about. We have and what we call a relevant truth. Relevant truth is what's relevant to me. All of us deal with a relevant truth. But God wants us to deal with an absolute truth. Relevant for you might not be relevant for me. You need to understand that, because people get upset because they don't make a distinguish between relevant truth and absolute truth. Many times, because of the way we was raised, it's relevant to us. We would rather fight than to switch. Mm-hmm. Okay, where you are and where you come from, you can't get away too much from your training. It's be a part of you. The story was told by a young lady. She got married and she was throwing away part of her chicken. And the husband said, "Babe, what's up with that?" And she said, "Well, I don't know. I'm just doing what I saw Mama do."
Well,
said, "Well, let's go over there and ask mother-in-law what's up with that, because you know." She went over there to mother-in-law and asked mother-in-law, the wife said, she said, "Oh no, I was just doing what I saw my mama do." And they said, "Mom, your mama is really sick and they got up in the air, but let's go over there and find out her." She said, "Oh, I was just doing that with throwing that part because my pot was too small." So sometimes what is relevant to you is not relevant to me. Things that we argue over is irrelevant to someone else, but it's relevant to me. So what we need to do is to go back to, well, the Lord says, John 8:32, you shall know the truth. The truth won't have you majoring in your minors. We major in our minors when we holding on to my relevant truth. That's my greatest fear, being deceived. To be deceived means to be misled. One of the definitions is to be misled.
That's right. Uh-huh. Good word.
Now, you shall know the truth, not a relevant truth, because if you know there is a way, according to Proverbs 12 and 14, there was a way which seemeth right unto man. That's a relevant truth. Mm-hmm. But the end thereof is the way of death.
Oh, yeah.
You shall know the truth. This is why I want to continue in the apostles' doctrine.
Yeah.
I don't care how many thousands and thousands following him or her. If it's not preaching the apostles' doctrines, that's a relevant truth. Another definition is to cause to believe a lie. When you're deceived. Jesus left it on record. He says to his disciples, let no man. Is that in your Bible? Do what? Take heed when people are talking. Don't be so carried away with your relevant truth until you can't take heed to what people are saying.
All right.
Husbands and wives,
hold on to relevant truth and destroy marriage.
Sisters and brothers, in-laws and outlaws, hold on to relevant truth and tap good relationships. You're being deceived. You need to know it. It's the devil. The Bible calls him a deceiver. Say he has come to earth. Devil don't take nobody to hell. The devil deceive you into going, taking your own self to hell.
The devil tricks you into going to hell. The devil traps you into going to hell. The devil can't send you to hell.
Amen. Good word,
Apostle.
That's a good word,
isn't it? You take yourself willingly to hell.
No.
Sister Cooper tells us they traps the wild hog.
Amen.
Sister Jack, you can't
just go to the trap. How you gonna catch a wild hog with a trap?
No, when you put the bait down, you put a little bait over here. Here is the bait, and here is one of the walls. The hog comes in up here.
I need to give you some little baits, and I'm almost through. You put your bait here. Let me get this down. This is gonna do me justice. And the hog up here eating, and you done put a fence back. You done put a wall back here. Here's the wall.
Mm-hmm. And you come back, you put some more bait up there. The hog, instead of coming, you put a wall over here. You can have a fist in after a while. You get my point. That's, and you put some more bait up there. You got two walls. Now you got your... You got the three walls.
But you
yes. And you keep putting your bait up there.
And before you know it, you got four walls and a trap door. You put a trap door there and you put the string on the trap door. Mm-hmm. And when he come in at last, then he just got a little hole to come in. Now he look all around and he see that food, he smell the food. He walks up in there and his leg hits that and the latch
slides down. Now he in there running around trying to get out, but he can't get out. And that's where the devil does us.
Go ahead.
He put fornication. hope y'all ain't ready for that. He put a little crack cocaine. He put a little cheating. That's for folks that already got somebody. He knows what we like because he called our body his house.
That's right.
He lived here.
My Lord.
Because he occupied it before we got saved. We was born in sin, and if you was born, he owned you
before God did.
That's right.
The devil sold us out. Jesus had to come and redeem us and buy us back. Jesus says, when the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest and findeth none. And he said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to give me some of my brothers. I'm going back to my house. Calling your temple. And said, when he come back, he finds it clean. Swept and garnished. But it's empty. Oh, y'all ain't ready for me. Another definition for being deceived is to cause to be beguiled. We're letting little stuff separate us.
Lord, help
me. We're letting little things keep us apart.
Yes.
You're being beguiled. You're being misled. You're being hoodwinked. You're being bamboozled. You're being cheated.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead.
Another definition means to impose upon.
Oh, Lord. The devil just impose upon us.
My Lord.
His junk.
Yeah.
And we accept it.
Yeah.
We ought to know better.
Yeah. We should not let the sun go down upon I mess.
Amen.
I don't care what people have said,
done, or doing. I'm not trying to impress nobody.
All right.
I'm trying to be seen.
Amen.
When I stand before God, I want to hear him say, well, done, Satan.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sure, you're right.
You did all right, boy. Come on home.
All right. Yes.
Because I've lived long enough to know in this life, Jesus didn't hoodwink us. He didn't try to bamboozle us. He said, in this life, you shall have tribulations. And many times they start in-house. They start among family members. In-house. And they spread abroad. Did you hear about Dr. Cooper and Sister Cooper? No, child, what? Did you hear about Apostle and Alicia say? You mean Apostle say? No, that wasn't done.
That's right. You have
and when somebody else tell it, they don't quite get it. The Bible said, if you believe a lie, you shall be
damned.
It's all over your Bible. Now, damn don't mean somebody cuss you out. I wish it did. No, all words have two meanings.
That's
he
right.
Gonna take it and come gonna take it.
That's right.
You know, but I said, I wish it would because I can live with that. But I can't live with standing before God. He said, depart from me. Your work was iniquity.
That's what Jesus said. He that believes in his baptized shall be saved, but he that believes not shall be damned, which means to be cut off.
Amen.
Amen.
Help us, Jesus.
If you believe a lie, you're going to be cut off. That's why I work hard. Now, I'm not all that smart. I'm not highly educated. But the Lord blessed me with wisdom.
All right.
I would rather have wisdom than to have
LeBron James money.
All right.
I rather have wisdom than to have Michael Jordan's record. I rather have wisdom. The word deceive means to be deluded, a delude. It means to be ensnared. And I'm gone now. It means to be ensnared. Watch what the writer says in 2 John, verse number 7. For many deceivers, is that in your Bible? Are entering into the world. Many, I ain't talking about Sister Minnie, many deceivers have entered into the world. And my brothers and sisters, Jesus said the other day, if it was possible, these folks are so smooth, they are so convincing, they will fool the very elect. But just tell your neighbor, the message is today. Say, I refuse to be a fool. Because the fool have said in his heart, there is no God. And when you feel like you are self-directing, oh, you're dangerous to be around. So the Bible says, for many deceivers are entered into the world who confess not that Jesus Christ is coming in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist. Mm-hmm. What antichrist means, against Christ, against God. Not only that, this book tells us that if they come into your house and don't bring this doctrine, don't even receive them in. Watch verse number 10, and I'm going to try to leave you. If therefore come any into you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. And we are running everywhere.
Well, child, these are good people. We are running and listen.
You can't mix with everything. Now you need to know that God don't want you to be antisocial, because the devil is deceiving some of the apostolic folks.
Yeah, I ain't going over there. Why?
Man,
I go over there and do my dance, but I ain't going over there and change what I'm doing.
All right.
Because I heard Paul says in the book of Ephesians chapter number 3, he says that we ought to be able to comprehend with all saints. Mm-hmm. Because the love of God passes all understanding. And that's all God told me to tell somebody this morning. Refuse to be a fool. Uh-huh. Because, amen, if you're being deceived, you're being misled. You're being misguided. You're being, amen, bamboozle, you being hoodwinked. Oh, glory to God. And Galatians says, 6:3, when a man thinketh himself to be something, when he or she is nothing, you're walking around now with your head all up in the air, deceiving your own self. We must learn how to humble ourselves. I'm going to have to get through now. Amen. We must learn how to know that we need God. I don't care what you have ascertained and accomplished in life. You still need God. God says, amen, the deceiver will cause you, amen, to be beguiled. He will ensnare you. He will enslave us, because, amen, he knows, amen, that he can outfox us. The Bible says the children of this world is wiser than the children of light. We got to understand that there's so many ways to be deceived. Mm-hmm. Amen. Con artists. con artist is nothing but a deceiver. They'll make you believe in what they are saying. And they will make you believe in what they are done. Because just like a man, the trap was set for the wild hawk. That's what the devil is doing us. He'll throw us a little of something we lack. And we'll be so focused trying a man to get it until we refuse to notice the trap. But the Lord says, be not deceived. Don't let the devil deceive you. Don't let the devil trick you. Don't let the devil delude you. Don't let the devil impose himself upon you. Don't let the devil beguile you. And don't let the devil lead you astray. One of the definitions that I love here, a man is leading astray. You got to be careful. I wanted the priest be careful for nothing. But the Lord said, no, just tell my peoples, a man, be not deceived. Amen. Work hard, church of to be not deceived. I don't care what people saying and what people's done. You got a Bible and you can read for yourself. Find out what God said and be a doer of the word and not just a hearer thereof. Because so many deceivers have already entered into the world. And God said, I'm coming back. I'm coming back for a church without spot or blemish, a wrinkle or any such thing. People are saying you can do what you want to do now. It don't make any difference. You just do what you want to do. You just go where you want to go. But God saying, come out from among them and be separate, said the Lord, and I will receive you unto myself. And that's all God told me to share with you this morning. Don't be deceived. If you owe someone an apology, I talked with a bishop on yesterday, and then another bishop, amen, he said that man owed me an apology, and I ain't talking to him no more until he tell and give me my apology. I said, well, brother, you got to understand, because I was working on my message. I said, the devil is a deceiver. If you don't forgive him until he come and apologize, the devil got both of y'all going to hell. You might go to hell by yourself, but I'm not going along with you. The Bible said if your brother have an order against you, you need to go to him. Don't sit around letting the devil deceive you. Well, he did me wrong. She did me wrong. No, you ought to go back to your brother. Go back to your son, your daughter. Go back to your friend. Throw your arms around them and say, Lord, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Because you could cause someone else to stumble. Amen. With your mess. It ain't worth it, y'all. Don't care what people done did to you, with you, in you, and for you. You got to forgive them. You know how big I am on forgiving it. And you got to forget it, get over it, and let it go. God saying, when you hold on to it, you're being deceived. When you won't let go, you're being deceived. When we throw that rock and try to hide our hands, we're being deceived. The eyes of the Lord is in every place. He sees everything we do. He hears everything we say. Don't be deceived. Oh, don't be deceived. Oh, don't be deceived. Oh, don't be deceived, because we don't know when it's his time to call and our time to answer. We want to be ready when he comes. Is anybody here this morning who want to be ready when the Lord comes? Let me hear you say yes. Let me hear you say yes. Let me hear you say yes. Oh, yes. Woo! If you owe someone an apology, if you done said something, and if they didn't hear it, you just go back to God. If that message found you, you'll come to this altar and say, Lord, it is me. I won't. From this day forward, I will not be deceived. I want you more than I want anything else upon this earth. I want you, Lord. If you are here today, what we're going to do, we're getting ready for communion. We're not going to have the prayer line. Amen. We're going to do our communion. But if you are here, and there are some things before you break bread today, nobody got to be inquisitive about what it is. Would you just come on up here? And we want to pray a mass prayer. There is room at the cross for you. At my age now, I really ain't got no time to waste. There is room. I just want the best for God's people. At the cross for you. When everybody's right. Everybody ain't nobody did nothing. Dominion.
Nobody ever said anything.
Has come. Still there is room for just one, and that one can be you. There is room at the cross for you.